Lecture number 2. Now we are going to classify the carbohydrates. See, the carbohydrates, they are very first classified as the sugars and non-sugars. When I say sugars, they are crystalline in nature, they are sweet in taste, they are soluble in water. So these are the properties of the sugar. When I say it's a non-sugar, so they are amorphous in nature. They are insoluble in water, they are tasteless, so they are non-sugars. Now, the next classification of the sugars is based on the hydrolysis of them. Sugars are classified as monosaccharides. Cannot, mono matlab one, they cannot be hydrolyzed further, that is called as a mono. One ko divide kar sakte hai kya? No, monosaccharides. These are oligosaccharides. यहाँ पे मैंने लिखा है oligosaccharides. Oligosaccharides मतलब they will yield 2 to 9 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis. They are called as the oligosaccharides. Now, next, तो monosaccharides को कैसे classify किया? They are classified on the base of the functional group as aldoses. Aldehyde as a functional group, aldoses and ketoses. Ketoses मतलब the functional group is a ketone, तो वो हो गया ketoses. Aldoses, ketoses. Next, now they are further classified depending on the number of carbon atoms. Aldopentose, functional group is aldehyde and the number of carbon atoms are 5. तो ये सबका molecular formula is this C5H10O5. Okay, what are the examples of it? Arabinose, xylose, ribose are the examples of it. So what are they? They are aldopentose. Ye ho gaya aldopentose. Next, aldohexose. Hexose, 6 carbon atoms and the functional group is an aldehyde. So what are the examples of it? Glucose, galactose, GG. Glucose, galactose. ये मैंने याद कैसे रखा? मतलब AXR, arabinose, xylose, ribose. Next, keto pentose मतलब the functional group is ketone and the number of carbon atoms are 5. Ribulose. Same molecular formula रहेगा because they are the functional isomers of each other. Aldo pentose and keto pentose. दोनों में difference क्या है? सिर्फ उनका फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज डिफरेंट, दैट्स ऑल. नेक्स्ट, कीटो हेक्सोस, द एग्जांपल इज फ्रुक्टोज. फ्रुक्टोज किधर आया? एक्सेस ऑफ कीटो हेक्सोस, मतलब द फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज कीटोन एंड द फंक्शनल ग्रुप इज कीटोन एंड उसमें नंबर ऑफ कार्बन एटम्स कितने हैं? 6. नेक्स्ट, अभी ये तो हो गया मोनोसैकेराइड्स का. दिस वॉज regarding monosaccharides. Now, when I go for the next, oligosaccharides का मैंने classification वहाँ पे दिया है, okay? यहाँ पे दिया है oligosaccharides, same यहाँ पे दिया है. Oligosaccharides are classified as disaccharide. दो monosaccharides on hydrolysis, that is called as a disaccharide. Trisaccharide, they give 3 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, that is called as a trisaccharide. Tetrasaccharide, they give 4 molecules of monosaccharide, that is called as a tetrasaccharide. And along with them, I have given the examples. This is disaccharide ka, SML. SML ka matlab kya? Sucrose, maltose, lactose. Raffinose, trisaccharide. Matlab, trisaccharide matlab kya? They will give 3 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, that is called as a trisaccharide. Tetrasaccharide matlab, they will give 4 monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, that is called as a tetra. Tetra matlab 4. Stachyose, example of it. Okay, next, we go for the non-sugars. Non-sugar part, it's given there, non-sugar part. They will be classified as polysaccharides. Polysaccharides, many monosaccharide units on hydrolysis, that is called as a polysaccharide. What are the examples of polysaccharide? Starch, cellulose, dextrin. These are all the polysaccharides. What is the formula of it? See, I have written it X. X मतलब क्या? ये हो गया polymer. So they are called as polysaccharides. What is it? That is the classification of the carbohydrate. Okay? That is the classification of carbohydrate. So it's all for this lecture today.